Lawmakers, dignitaries, and survivors came together tonight for the Maryland Network Against Domestic Violence's annual memorial service. The event raises awareness and it garners support for families affected by domestic violence. 11 News reporter Kim Dacey was there, and she has the story tonight from Annapolis.
The memorial service here in Annapolis served to not only advocate for legislation regarding domestic violence, but also to honor the victims and the survivors.
Timothy Paul Weekend, age 35. Killed by strangulation.
One by one, the names of victims of domestic violence who lost their lives last year in Maryland are called. Janet Blackburn's sister, Gail Pumphrey, and Gail's three children were shot to death in a Montgomery County park on Thanksgiving Day in 2007. Since then, she's made it a point to attend the vigil every year.
I'm an advocate for these victims, and this just fuels my fire when I can come in here and I can see the number of victims.
Janet helped create stricter domestic violence laws in Maryland, and this year there are more bills facing the General Assembly. One creates a stiffer punishment for abusers who violate protective orders. Another is called the Safe Homes Act.
To just make tenant laws a little more flexible in a situation where someone has to flee or someone needs help changing locks because of domestic violence or something.
I think anything we can do to help to protect these victims is important.
The key to getting the legislation passed into law is sometimes the result of survivors and family members like Janet, something Governor Martin O'Malley pointed out.
You know, you can roll out and rattle off all the statistics and legislation that you like, but what people remember are personal stories. And that's what drives it home.
And Janet Blackburn says it's important to remember the person behind each and every name that was called.
They're not statistics. These people are people that are loved by families. And I can tell you firsthand that these families will carry this pain in their heart the rest of their lives.
Governor O'Malley says the state has a goal to reduce the incidence of violence against women and children by 25% by the year 2012. In Annapolis, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.